Scribd is a book subscription service that makes unlimited books available for $8.99 per month. And what we wanted to do was expand it to other kinds of written content. So we'd be a subscription service for all kinds of reading. And we went into audiobooks after ebooks, and then we decided comics was the next natural fit.
Are you going to get some big comics names to sign up as well, like DC?
Well, we currently have about a dozen of the biggest comics publishers in the world, including Marvel, IDW, Valiant, Archie. We don't have DC yet, but I think there's going to be a lot more publishers on the way, so there should be some more announcements soon.
And what about self-published comic books? Could that be on your service?
Yeah, so I think it's a great idea. We already have self-published content on Scribd, and there's a lot of comics on there, and I think we could definitely build out that part of the business.
Now, you're charging about $8.99 for unlimited subscription on Scribd. Is that a price that you feel that consumers are comfortable with?
Yeah, I think it's a very good price. It's very similar to what Netflix and Spotify both cost, and it's similar to what a lot of consumers spend on books in a typical month. So, unlimited ebooks, audiobooks, comics for $8.99 per month is a really good deal because it's a very good selection with a lot of quality content for a low monthly price.
Now, Scribd for books, audiobooks, and comics has been out for about a year and a half now. How many people have signed up?
So it's been growing at about 31% per month since we launched the book subscription service in October of 2013. So it's definitely getting a lot bigger and really starting to return some meaningful revenue to publishers.
Now, what about the economics of the business? I mean, how much money? What is that meaningful revenue for publishers?
What we do is we pay publishers whenever their content's read, and for some of our publishers, we're already one of their top three digital revenue sources, and that's continuing to grow really quickly.
Can you talk more about exactly how much you pay publishers?
I mean, so we pay them the price of the book or the price of the comic or the price of the audiobook. So it's as if they sold the content. So it's basically, for consumers, it's a subscription service where they pay once and they can read whatever they like. And for publishers, it's almost like another retail channel.
You've been called the Netflix or the Spotify of books. Which one is the better comparison?
Uh-huh. I think they're both pretty good. I mean, I think that both services are fundamentally a way to subscribe, to listen to or watch different kinds of content and have a new kind of experience for exploring and discovering new things to watch or listen to, and I think we do the same thing for reading. So I think we're similar to both, and we're also different from both of them. So, I mean, we're kind of our own thing.
So do you have big Netflix dreams? I mean, how big is Scribd going to get?
It's a good question. I mean, we've been growing 31% per month, and I don't see that slowing down anytime soon. I mean, we're really just getting started. We're going to be adding a lot more content, both with ebooks, with audiobooks, with comics, and with new types of content. And we also have a lot of things we're going to do to the product. We're going to really improve the discovery experience for books. We're going to make it improve the reading experience. We're going to make it more social for books, so you can discover books through your friends. So I think as we do all this, it's just going to continue to grow, and I think it could be a really